Oops. Today, which is we're gonna try and create the best holiday look. And do any of you care to explain like what kind of holiday look you're going for?
No,
because I have no idea either. So, and I was thinking
I do, but I didn't want to explain
it. You're just gonna a surprise.
I don't even know like how to do eyeshadow that well. So
me neither. So
what do you think?
I think we are like we're good at doing makeup on ourselves.
Yeah.
But when it goes to like a cut crease,
yeah,
doing that stuff,
like, I have no idea.
I learned how to cut crease. Thank you, Taikia. Shout out to you, girl. I don't think I'm going to, but we'll see.
I would love to do a cut crease.
Oh, sure. I just got to spell it. So I'm
also, I don't have like fancy makeup or whatever. I just really don't do makeup at all.
Yeah.
And you're going to see me pull stuff out and you're going to be like, well, Charlotte looks like a lot of makeup. But I don't.
Without further ado,
let's get into the video. Rose, when y'all was growing up.
No.
Y'all never heard of fucking Jenna Rose, bro.
Nope. I heard of Jenna Marbles.
That's what I thought she was talking about. I was like, who? Jenna Marbles?
Jenna.
You mean Jenna Marbles?
Jenna Marbles.
There was a song about her.
Who did it?
But Jenna Rose, she made, y'all should look her up. Look up Jenna Rose, OMG.
Look at this.
Oh, that's what I wanted to hear.
Oh my gosh.
I was trying to have it. It's not.
Huh?
What is that?
That's my beauty blender.
Girl, does she squeeze a bunch of concealer or something on there?
No, I'm just normally that dark.
I washed all of my brushes today.
I did it.
So proud of myself.
Oops, I'm sorry. Sorry.
Shout out to anybody that knows schoolgirls.
Oh, I know schoolgirls are not broke. Alright, guys, I'm very happy to say this.
On these damn lashes.
Yeah, why are you just filming your neck?
My neck. My back.
Snatched a bitch. Oh! Sorry.
So I'm gonna film this only because I want everyone to see how bad I struggle with liquid eyeliner. Okay, I'll set this dry. It's turning out all right. I don't. Look at that.
Oh, you fucking bitch!
For someone not knowing how to do eyeliner, that came out pretty good.
Something's gone good for someone.
You know, you just gotta trust in your work. You can't be so hard on yourself, even if it may look like crap.
Now
that's how I think about my life.
What? I'm playing.
Okay, wait, I think I might have
to say the Christmas tree.
Okay.
And they put the whatchamacallits on it.
The what?
Gold. Girl!
What?
Oh my god!
A black Christmas tree.
And there was a time when I
feel nasty.
Your teeth?
Mm-hmm.
You thought what? You were gonna get married?
Honestly though,
yeah,
I feel bad because I've been having those thoughts like
you're not gonna
marriage.
Fall in love?
That I probably wouldn't get married.
Me too.
And that's so bad.
No, I've had those thoughts too because like you always see couples that like when marriage comes into play, issues arise.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
you know? And then, like, but the relationship's the same. The only thing that changed was marriage. And then, like, with marriage comes sharing everything.
I don't care about that.
No, I mean, I don't either, but that's, like...
But also, even though I had that thought, but it also helped me realize I'm not, you don't seek for a relationship. You don't, I mean, you eventually want one, yes, but when you're talking to guys, you don't come up to them and be like, yeah, I initially want to be in a relationship. You don't understand what's to come out of this person. And so it's helped me realize, oh, there's a lot of failing relationships because people have not taken the time to just like,
get to know the other person?
That, and just to get to know their self or discover what they want. Because usually people that want a relationship don't want a relationship. They just like the idea of it. And you don't really understand what's going into that and all that it entails. So, like, when I talk to guys now...
I think I fall victim to that.
So, when I talk to guys now... I take a different approach because I don't know what has recently, like, made me discover that, but I have, like,
right. Okay.
It's so been a shift.
What do you say to the people who say, you date to marry? What do you say
well,
to that?
Well, it's still a date to marry thing. It's just, you don't come up to a, first of all, like, you can't approach a, I guess, trying to build a relationship with somebody. Yes. You don't approach it as, this is going to be my boyfriend. We're going to get, you'd have to play things out. Part of building a relationship is not calculating it. I didn't go up to you guys and was like, we're going to be friends. We're going to be best friends.
We're
going to
do this and this.
That's not how it worked. We came naturally. What formed? And we always talk about it. We never, you know, why people say, I don't know how we met. Or
right.
Because they allowed their relationship to be natural.
Right, because I can't remember.
And that's, you want to have
that. I literally don't remember.
Oh, yeah, I like to use a brush.
I'm sorry, I should use that because I can't find my spool. But
I have a spool, I just use my brush.
I was not expecting that.
I have several. And that's what people need to apply to any relationship. Is like, if you would stop fantasizing the idea of a friend, a best friend, a boyfriend, a girlfriend, and just let the relationship and let time do its thing, then you will be able to enjoy yourself more and you'll actually be able to realize what you want from that person. Then you'll start to realize, did I even want a relationship from that person? Mm-hmm. Like, I got to know you, and it's like with some friends, you get to know people and you're like, they're not a good influence on my life, and they have to cut them off, you know?
Right.
There is no difference in when you're talking to somebody and you're trying to pursue a romantic relationship. It's a relationship. The same concepts, I guess, apply. And so I've just come to learn that. And so my approach to talking to guys or with this dating, whatever you want to call it, is different. Not that I don't eventually, like, of course I'm going to aspire to get a relationship, but it's not that I'm, that's not the intention at front hand. You know what I mean? Because my moment, like, I might be, like, at the time, I might not want a relationship right now. But who's to say when I continue to talk to this person, I might not want one later, you know?
Right.
Because
like,
we put
that's
that
part
time.
About getting to know the person. And, like, I've always said that you could not be attracted to it. Because people say, like, there all those are people that, like, oh, attraction comes first. Like, you have to be attracted to the person. And, like, I can sort of see that. But when you like somebody, right, everything that they do becomes attractive to you.
Very true.
So once you get to know that person, and, like, in the beginning, if it's not attraction, if it's not whatever, once you get to know them more on, things suddenly start to become an attraction to you.
Yeah. No more sink.
I have to let my beauty go.
Okay. Need some water for baby. Here's the thing about that. I've also discovered that I feel like attraction plays an important, like, attraction does come first. And what I mean by that is, yeah, you're going to get attracted to the, like, you, I'm not going to sit here and lie and act like
attraction
doesn't matter.
Factor, yeah.
Right. But there might be somebody you didn't, like, usually when it comes to the personality type of people, it's usually someone I didn't find attractive at all.
Right.
And then you started talking
right.
to them.
Right.
That's what I'm saying. That's the part that comes into getting to know the person that plays a huge role.
I used to be the person, though, that would be like, they're not really attractive, but let me see what they are personality-wise. And that would just, like, I guess not cut it for me.
Because you weren't attracted to them?
Because I wasn't attracted to them, and I was kind of, like, trying to, like, downplay, well, I don't find them cute, but maybe their personality is good, but they were...
Hey, that's kind of like,
Alright, so we're back with our final looks. Who wants to go first?
I will.
Oh, something didn't happen. I have a low battery. It's fine.
Is it still recording?
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. We're gonna do it from afar, just a little bit, because like from afar it looks better.
Yeah, me too.
You know?
Yeah. We're not beauty gurus.
Yeah, that's for sure. Char said the first look.
It's still on you.
Well, it wasn't when you were leaning.
Oh.
The first look, or the first name Char came up was like a Christmas fairy. Something, and then she came up with a touch of green. So I think we're gonna go with a touch of green because that's what the eyes insinuate. And basically I had no idea what I was doing until I touched the green in the pan and I accidentally put it on my eyeball and I said, let me go with it, let me run with it. And I'm pretty proud of how it came out because, you know, when I can't do wing eyeliner, you can get in close for that and just, you know.
Sure.
Next.
Thank H. you. Next.
That was damn it. That I thought. Me. Damn it. I was really like, okay, so we don't have the thing going on. So, hi guys, I'm Kendall, and
this is my story.
This is my look. I call this. I don't know what to call this. Actually, I don't think I came up with a name. What did she do?
She's zooming in and out on you. Oh, I did not see the lips, ma'am. Yes.
I don't have a name for mine, but I really don't have a lot of colorful, like, anything besides red. So then, shut up. So then, can you stop that? Stop! So then, I was like, okay, I feel like Mrs. Claus, and I put this thing on my head to... She's calling me about cleaning the kitchen. I have to go do that. But anyway, so I was like, this reminds me of like candy canes or Mrs. Claus, and I decided to go for a Mrs. Claus look. So I have a bunch of like touches of red in there, even white, and I was like, red and white, they're Christmas colors.
Oh dear, tell your story.
Okay, well, I don't really have a story. I got a new makeup palette. I got the Saharan palette by Javi's Place, and I just wanted to test it out. So I really thought that this blue on my eyes was green, and then it turned out blue. So that's that. I'm kind of happy it is blue because it kind of looks like frosted, like a winter wonderland-ish look. And then I added some gold in there because, you know, I have to add those highlights, and that's basically it for me.
Love that.
Walking in a winter wonderland. Snow Tierra the Snowman. This is what I call it.
Snow Tierra the Snowman?
Wait.
It's a long name.
Frost Tierra the Snowman. Okay.
There
we go.
It's cute.
Basically.
It is. What's this song? Get in.
Watching Vlogmas Day 4. We hope you enjoyed it. Let us know in the comments who did the best look. You can say all three because, like, we all slayed, but, like, if you have a preference, let us know.
Don't hesitate.
Don't hold back either because, yes, I know we're not the best, but we slayed. We did a good job. High five. All right. Please like, comment, subscribe. You left her hanging.
Share.
Oh, sorry. And tune in tomorrow for Vlogmas Day 5.
All you ladies pop your pussy like this. Shake your body, don't stop, don't miss. All you ladies pop your pussy like this. Shake your body, don't stop, don't miss. Just do it, do it, do it.
Okay, back in action part 3.